Imagine that on a very ordinary Monday morning, you could wake up and start getting ready for work not in the office, but on an orbital station that helps humanity extract energy from the sun. Coffee is made by your personal robot assistant, and you fly there in a few minutes on your home transport capsule, because teleportation is already quite a bother. And in the evening, you don't go to a nearby cafe or just drink coffee, but fly to a neighboring planet, because that's where the best chef in the entire galaxy lives, who prepares mind-blowing calzones. What if I told you that you could live to see such a day? Back in 1964, the Soviet scientist Nikolai Kardashev created a scale that classifies global civilizations according to their level of development. He determined that the progress of society depends on two things: energy and technology. The more energy a civilization has, the more technology it can create. And the more useful technologies are created, the more new energy can be controlled. Unfortunately, humanity, with all its achievements, SpaceX, iPhones, and Amazon, still hasn't even reached the first level of this scale. We now proudly occupy the position of a zero-level civilization. How much do we need to do to reach the first level? According to data on global energy consumption, we've passed only 0.16%. To make this clearer, if we compare the level of humanity to a dive into the depths of the Mariana Trench, we have barely wet our feet running away from the wave. We'll reach the first level when humanity learns to extract energy from everything on the planet. Imagine that we'll be able to control earthquakes, tsunamis, and the force of gravity. We'll be able to extract energy from everything around us. Probably there'll be such professions as electrician of ocean waves or tamer of the movement of continental plates. Sounds cooler than manager. Electricity will be extracted from almost everything around us. The issue of charging all our gadgets from the network will become history. Batteries will always be at 100%. The same factor will also affect the charging of your electric cars, finally turning them into an ideal, eco-friendly way to travel around the planet. Rain will no longer be a way to hide tears when parting with your girlfriend, but a unique charge for heating homes, and the developed technologies will turn forest fires into a way to green the planet, because their energy will help irrigate and fertilize trees planted on the site of the burned forest. We'll finally stop extracting minerals from the Earth's interior and thus stop depleting our home planet. But this is all kind of simple and boring. At the second level, civilization will be able to subdue the energy of the sun and the entire solar system. This already looks like the beginning of a script for a new Hollywood blockbuster starring Will Smith. Humanity has already figured out how to do this. Inspired by science fiction novels, American physicist Freeman Dyson came up with a sphere that received his last name. The Dyson sphere is a structure in the form of a huge shell. By huge, we're referring to a galactic scale that covers the sun. No Babe Ruth could hit a ball like that, right? Its main function is to extract the energy of a central star. Sounds ambitious. Exactly the same as the people who will populate not only the Earth, but also the rest of the planets of our system. Venusians and Martians will be like Frenchmen or Spaniards to us, just people from a neighboring planet who can fly for a visit on intergalactic low-cost airlines, save for $50 both directions. I think you'll have to spend an hour and a half traveling, because a good hour of time will be spent waiting for your luggage at baggage claim. Yes, some things in this world are eternal. But this is far from the limit of perfection. Imagine that we could subdue our entire galaxy, all of the stars and planets of the Milky Way, and give their energy to humanity. Dang, this is unbelievable. Fasten your seatbelts. We're moving to the third level. Now, the entire galaxy is under energy control. In our case, humanity will completely harness the Milky Way galaxy. This isn't only all the planets, but also all the stars. We'll build a myriad of Dyson spheres and become the true masters of the world. Imagine that schools will conduct excursions to the Dyson sphere systems. The Galaxy Soccer Championship will be held every 4 light years to allow all players to prepare for the tournament, because the average life expectancy of a person is likely to be approximately infinite. Why? Don't forget that energy storage is now possible not only in material media, but also inside each person. Each of us is a small battery that is constantly being fed. Even the usual dinner, instead of being a mandatory procedure, will turn into a way of passing time and spent for your own satisfaction. My grandmother's phrase, "If you don't want to eat, don't eat," takes on a whole new meaning. After this description, questions arise in my head. What will happen next? The Kardashev classification was ably expanded by science fiction writer Helge Kautz and added several more levels to the classification of civilization. Get ready to unleash your imagination to the fullest. We're moving to the fourth level. Energy is collected and accumulated from all possible galactic superclusters. Each galaxy now has its own Dyson sphere. Here, we can safely say that people are the kings of everything that exists. Completely. Well, not just yet. This is waiting for us at the fifth level, because it's here that we'll get access to all the energy that is available in the universe. Each micron will be able to charge your smartphone. It's during this period that civilization begins not only to extract energy from everywhere, but also to change the laws of physics with its help. Schools will no longer teach Newton's laws, because each of them could easily be changed. Poor Isaac will go mad in the next world and realize that the apple fell on his head for nothing. Okay, but there's also a sixth level. Yes, there's much further and something still much cooler. Let me tell you one phrase that will help you understand it all. We'll be able to light the stars. Yes, the sun went out and we lit it back up. They took a huge defibrillator and resuscitated our star. It may seem that in the last levels, we'll reach the level of the gods. And here the question arises, how real is all this? On the one hand, the probability that humanity will reach even the second level of civilization is still too small. And this whole theory can only be an excuse for writing a new science fiction novel, which Christopher Nolan will then want to make a movie based on. On the other hand, we evolved from primitive Australopithecines to intelligent people about 5 million years ago. 100 years ago was a luxury for a person to just wash themselves. And now you can find out what is happening anywhere in the world with your thumb and a smartphone gadget that's accessible to everyone. The speed of our development is growing. Raymond Kurzweil, futurologist and technical director of Google, claims that in the year 2045, there will be a technological singularity. What does this mean? In his opinion, humanity will unite and turn the Earth into one giant computer, which will speed up progress and make it so fast that every moment there will be a scientific discovery. Who knows? Maybe in such a world, it will no longer be a problem for us to subdue the energy of an entire galaxy. It may well be that in a few decades, we'll see a completely new classification where the current level of development will seem to us like primitive times. I hope that science and man's quest for knowledge will open up possibilities that we can't even guess at yet.